गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, आई एम वैशाली धनोकर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर आईटी डिपार्टमेंट। इन माय लास्ट वीडियो वी लर्न अबाउट डिफरेंट प्रोटोटाइपिंग टेक्निक्स, राइट? नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट द नेक्स्ट टेक्निक, दैट इज वायर फ्रेमिंग इन एफसीआई। सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज मीन बाय वायर फ्रेमिंग। नेक्स्ट, फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स आर कवर्ड इन दिस वीडियो विच इंक्लूड्स व्हाट इज वायर फ्रेमिंग, कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ वायर फ्रेमिंग, then examples of wire framing, advantage and disadvantages regarding wire framing technique. Let's see one by one. And the first point is, what is wire framing? Next. So wire framing is one kind of concept. Okay. This concept generally used by the designer in software development lifecycle phase. Wire framing is a way to design a website service in the structural level. Wireframe is commonly used to layout content, functionality and visual designs on a page, which takes into account user needs and user journeys. It means that as per the user requirements, you should develop a particular design of that particular software. Okay? So wireframe means sequential way how exactly that particular system will be worked. Wireframes are used in early development process to establish the basic structure of page before visual design and content is added. Designer design a particular software by using some particular application, right? But wireframing is this technique just the basic structure of the page. Wireframing represents a sketch, blueprints or page layout of the design. It also created using variety of software applications. So this is the concept of wireframing. Wireframing simply means to develop or design a particular software as per their steps or stages, right? Next. Now, the components of wireframing. These are the some basic components of wireframing. Each wireframe has following components. You should see these all types of components in each types of application, like Microsoft Word, then PowerPoint, then Microsoft Excel, different types of gaming applications, notepad, then browser. These all kind of applications, these all types of components are available. These are the some basic or common components. So the first component is title. Title indicate that describe the purpose of applications, right? And title always present top of left top of each screen, right? Next, how to get there, that is name and location of application. There are some hyperlinks are present. When you click on that particular hyperlink, the particular videos will be open, right? So how to get there means name and location of application. Location also indicated the particular application where we will store in our software or in our computer system. That is location or path, right? Next, concept. Concept describes what the objectives for this panel. There is particular description of that particular software or application, which is called as concept, right? Concept generally used in history panel, right? Or in description box. Next, contents or data. It describes all contents on panel, including buttons or icons. There are different types of contents, like buttons or icons are present on the screen. And these are the common types of contents, right? And the next is if-then condition. It describes the user behavioral of the result. Okay, suppose if you pressed on the particular button, then what result will be generated? This is the condition of if then condition. If you pressed on OK button, then what will be happen? If you pressed on submit button, then what will be happen? Right. So there are different types of common buttons like OK, submit, login, sign up, cancel, this kind of, right? So it describes the user behavioral result. Okay. The next component is navigation link. Navigation link describes hyperlinks as well as navigation links, right? Navigation links means some the link of that particular video or the application. Okay. The link of how to download that particular software, right? So this kind of all the links are present, which is called as hyperlink or navigation link. Next, error condition. Error condition describes any errors that may result from user behavior. sometimes there are some errors will be generated. Suppose the particular column, there is H column, okay, and you should add the H in negative format, that is suppose minus 19, okay. So it generate the errors, right. So it describe the error as per the user results behavior, clear. So these are the components of wireframing. Titan, then how to get there, concept, contents of data, if then condition, navigation link and error condition. So these are the one of the most important components of wireframing technique. All the wireframing technique are based on this kind of components, etc. Clear? Next. So now there are some examples of wireframing technique. See here, suppose there are three buttons are present. Suppose you click on the second button, that is my playlist. You will go through this screen, right? The next recommended, this type of button is present, right? And suppose you click on this first playlist song, then you should go to another playlist item in this way, right? So these are the one by one step wise approach, right? And these are called a wireframing approach. Okay? So the name indicate that wire means the connection between each and every screen. Okay? And framing means frame. Means when you click on particular frame, the next another frame is open, right? You should analyze those things in your mobile, right? Suppose WhatsApp, there are three types of frame, that is chatting, then calls applications, then contacts, etc., right? So there are different types of frames and all the frames are connected through the wire. So this concept is called as wire framing, right? Next. Now again, there are some another examples of wireframing technique. See here, this is just a kind of flow chart, okay. Suppose there is email address, password and sign up page, okay. Initially there is sign in or register. Suppose you click on sign in, it goes to next page. Again, after entering email address or password, again sign in, then again it goes to next page, right, in this way. So this is called as wireframing technique. This design is generated before the design phase or basic structure, that is how your system would be look like in future, right? Again, this is another example of wireframing as per your mobiles or contents in mobiles, right? Next. Now, what are the advantages and disadvantages of wireframing technique? The main advantages is it involves client in design process. You should design a particular software, then submit it to the client. Client again redesign it as per the user requirements or client requirements, right? So involve client in design process. It's one of the most important thing. Then finalize content and visual elements of design. By using wireframing technique, you should finalize content, that which types of contents or components or visual elements are present in particular screen, right? You should make changes efficiently because wireframing is rough work, we can say that, a rough structure. So we can make changes efficiently. It saves time and cost because design once approved by the clients and user provide a confidence to designer. Wireframing design is approved by the client. So it will be final design or final work, right? Each and every content placed on page as per the user needs, right? So user requirement is one of the most important thing. So you should design a particular software as per the user needs. Now what are the disadvantages? Disadvantages means it's not included any design concept or technical details. Okay? You should not maintain any design concepts or technical details. That will be completely rough work or rough structure, right? Sometimes when designer transfer wireframes in design, it changes position of the element. Suppose you should draw a particular structure, rough structure, by using paper and pencil, right? And after that you should make a particular design by using software, that is actual design, right? But there are some maybe changes in that particular position of the components, right? Some changes will be happen as per the screen layout, page layout, etc. So these are the some disadvantages regarding that. Clear? Next. I hope so you understood the concept regarding wireframing technique. Keep practicing. Thank you.